President Donald Trump has been accused of so many things, most of which fall into the realm of hysterical fake news. But here's a new slur leveled against the president. Apparently, he's a slut shamer. Says who? Says Pocahontas, that's who. So President Trump and Senator Kirsten Gillibrand got into a brief Twitter war recently. Here's what the president had to say, quote, "Lightweight Senator Kirsten Gillibrand, a total flunky for Chuck Schumer and someone who had come to my office begging for campaign contributions not so long ago and would do anything for them, is now in the ring fighting against Trump. Very disloyal to Bill and crooked used," end quote. And Senator Gillibrand fired back with the following, quote, "You cannot silence me or the millions of women who have gotten off the sidelines to speak out against the unfitness and shame you have brought to the Oval Office," end quote. Wait a second. Shame in the Oval Office and woman? Is Ms. Gillibrand speaking of Bill Clinton here? No, she's not. But riddle me this. Why is it that the new face of the Democratic Party, Elizabeth Warren, you know, the one who is allegedly 1/32nd Cherokee when Warren needs to play that card for career advancement. Yeah, why is she calling the president's remarks slut-shaming? I've read and reread the tweet. I cannot find evidence of the president calling Gillibrand the S-word or any other sexist bleep word. But I guess when Pocahontas goes on the warpath, what do the facts of the matter have to do with anything? Because here's what Warren had to say about the tweet. President Trump was trying to bully, intimidate, and slut-shame her fellow Democrat. How so? Where so? For starters, if anyone of any gender doesn't want to contend with harsh language, politics should not be your chosen vocation. And is Warren so desperate to paint a bad picture of Trump that she'll accuse the president of you-know-what shaming? I mean, come on, it's not as if Trump was channeling Dan Aykroyd in his debates with Jane Curtin during SNL's Point Counterpoint segments.
Jane, you ignorant slut. Bagged up, dried up, slunk meat like you and Michelle Triola know the rules. If you want a contract, sign on the dotted line. Oh, but let's all shed a tear for poor Michelle Triola. There was only testimony that she had sexual intercourse over 40 times with another man while living with actor Lee Marvin. But I suppose that sort of fashionable promiscuity means nothing to someone like you, Jane, who hops from bed to bed with the frequency of a cheap ham radio.
So then, is the contentious phrase the reference that Gillibrand would do anything for Trump support? Well, if that's the case, why is Warren automatically assuming the president means something sexual when he uses the word anything? Why is Warren and her ilk jumping headfirst into the gutter, assuming that a commonplace figure of speech somehow automatically means a sexual act? Put another way, if he said Gillibrand would sell her soul to achieve her goals, would they dump on Trump for promoting Satanism? Well, give me a break. Oh, by the way, as an aside, I thought that the left thinks being loose is a good thing. Every year in cities around the world, there are slut walks in which certain women embrace the idea of being as a slut as a means of empowerment, right? Gee, it's all so confusing, isn't it? In any event, when you really think about it, the person guilty of slut shaming here is Elizabeth Warren. She's the one who has jumped to such a preposterous conclusion based on very generic language. But what this is really all about is that the Democrats will resort to just about any tactics to bring down this president. And Warren's ludicrous statement proves again that the left just can't resist using ad hominem attacks rather than logic when it comes to what passes for debate these days. For the Rebel.Media, I'm David the Menzoid Menzies. Like what you just saw? Then click subscribe below and never miss another Rebel video.